Hi friends, welcome to Aerotech Solutions. Let's see the next feature from 8051 microcontroller, which is serial communication. Basically, your microcontroller is supporting one standard protocol, which is UART. Okay, before proceeding, what is protocol and what way you are trying to communicate with external modules with microcontroller? So I'll give brief information on communication and what is the terminology you need to understand before entering into serial communication. So the final intention is very clear. Whenever you are trying to communicate two devices, I need to share the data between two devices. That is the main motto of any kind of communication. So, but if you are coming to specific this communication, you are going to change the names with the standard terminology as transmitters, receivers, and whatever the lines, whatever the physical lines or whatever the physical wires you are connecting between two devices, so this name which is treated as a bus. So every communication has its own terminology. You need to understand this. But the main motto of any kind of communication is very clear, looking to exchange the information between two devices. And again, the name which is serial communication, the other alternate option is parallel communication whenever you are proceeding with wires. So this is simple. The serial communication means you will find less number of physical lines between devices. The information which is transmitted or received bit by bit. So bit by bit means you are already aware every electronic device will deals with two standard logics, logic 1 and logic 0. The information you are looking to send or receive, which is in the form of bits, which is 1 or 0. Suppose you are proceeding this, the same information exchange between devices with more physical lines. So anyway, the parallel communication, in parallel communication, you are finding more physical lines between transmitter and receivers. So here also, you are allowing to share your information in the form of zeros and ones. And here also you are doing your information in the form of zeros and ones. But whereas in parallel, you are sending group of bits at a time and you are sending information bit by bit in the case of serial. But most of the cases, which communication you are going to prefer, either serial or parallel? So that is depends on type of application, whether your communication you are expecting between devices, whether it is long distance or short distance, or you are not expecting more physical lines between devices, you are expecting less complexity. Because so everything which is related to the complexity of your circuit, okay, if you are approaching parallel communication, you need to run more physical lines between devices. And if you are proceeding with serial communication, which is very simple to establish physical connection, so you will find only less number of physical wires between devices, 1, 2, or 3 wires max. This is how you can differentiate your serial versus parallel communications. And there are methods to send your information between devices, so which are simplex, half duplex, full duplex. That means the way of sending data between devices, if you are doing only one way, which means nothing you are receiving from other side device, so you are sending your information from only transmitter to receiver. You are not receiving anything from your receivers to transmitter, which is a unidirectional communication. Okay, so that method we can treat as a simplex. And the other method is half duplex. So there also you will find transmitter and receiver. But the receiver is also will become transmitter in the case of half duplex. But only one thing, you can do it at a time. So you can do both transmission and reception here as two devices. The transmitter can send information to receiver, and receiver also can send information to transmitter. Two things will happen here, but only one thing at a time, either transmission or reception. You cannot do both at a time in the case of half duplex. So the another method is full duplex. So this method, which allows to send your information transmitter and receiver at a time. So two things will happen at a time in the case of full duplex method. There are many examples you can take it for simplex method, like FM radio, like whatever you are allowing to hear, you can hear anything from station to your receiver side. And whereas half duplex, you can take the example walkie talkies. So one person is keeping receive mode, the other person will talk. If the other person wants to talk, then they have to keep it in receive mode. So that will happen in the case of half duplex. And full duplex are your mobile communication, which is all comes under your full duplex method. See, the information how you are passing, that will be differentiated by your serial and parallel, and way of information or way of communication, whether you are doing only receiving, that is simplex. You are doing both transmission and reception, but only one thing is possible at a time, that comes under half duplex. And you can do both transmission and receiving at a time, which is comes under full duplex. So this is how you can differentiate your serial and parallel and different methods. Now, so when any microcontroller which is going to support a few protocols to do your information exchange with other modules or other devices, so they are giving one last feature from microcontroller, which is serial port. So how to differentiate your serial port and IO port? So there are already IO ports with microcontrollers. These IO ports are also helping us to give the data to external device or take the information from external device to microcontrollers. But the serial port is, which is not going to work as same as your IO port, which will follows a standard protocol. If suppose it is a microcontroller, in between your microcontroller and external device, you need to understand the concept, which is protocol. The standard definition of protocol is some set of rules and regulations. Every microcontroller follows one protocol or more protocols, but every microcontroller has its own set of rules and regulations, which is treated as data frame. So every microcontroller has its own data frame. You need to understand that data frame means how your data is going to transmit and how your data is going to receive. So not your regular or random way, you cannot assign any data across serial ports. So you need to do some, you need to follow some rules and regulations, then only your data either transmits or receives. Okay, so what protocol which is supporting for us? So whereas 8051 is supporting serial communication. Serial communication means you are sending or receiving data bit by bit, and which protocol it is following, UART. So serial communication supports serial communication with UART protocol in half duplex method. Whereas UART means universal asynchronous reception and transmission. So this is one basic protocol in microcontrollers. So in coming our next level microcontrollers, you may find more protocol support like I2C communication, SPI communication, CAN communication, USB communication, Ethernet. And if you move to next level 32-bit category controllers, you may get Wi-Fi, which is wireless anyway, Bluetooth. So these are all the next level protocols supported by new generation controllers. But this is a very basic microcontroller which is supporting only one standard protocol, which is UART. So according to this UART protocol, the UART protocol data frame is very clear. which is having simple start bit, then data and stop bit. Then how to notice the microcontroller is supporting which kind of protocol, whether it is supporting UART or which is supporting USB or which is supporting I2C, based on the physical pins availability from the controllers. So whenever you are noticing that the microcontroller which is having RXD and TXD pins from pin diagram, so any microcontroller having these two physical lines, which is clearly indicates that this device follows UART protocol. Like this, every protocol has its own physical lines, having own physical lines from the device. Like if the device which is supporting I2C communication, then you may find SDA and SCL lines from the device, which is serial data line, serial clock line. And if any device supports SPA communication, you need to check the physical pins from the device, which is MISO, MOSI, which is master in, slave out, master out, slave. So these two are the two physical lines for SPA support devices. If you are expecting CAN protocol from the device, you need to notice the two standard physical pins, which are CAN-H and CAN-L. If any microcontroller is supporting USB protocol, you need to notice the two physical lines from the device, which are D+ and D-. Like this, every protocol has its own physical lines from the microcontrollers. From 8051 microcontroller, you will find only these two lines across pin number 10 and pin number 11. So these two are the pins, alternate functionalities of P3.0 and P3.1 pins. So this is how it is easy to notice from the microcontrollers which protocol which is supporting for us. So according to this, you can easily catch the microcontroller physical pin diagram. So if it is supporting SD and SCL lines, it supports I2C. If you are finding MISO, MOSI lines, which supports SPA communication. If you are finding CAN-H and CAN-L lines, which supports CAN communication. And if you are finding D+ and D-, which will support USB. These are all serial communication protocols from microcontrollers. So, but from 8051, we are finding only one basic protocol. But once you move on to any PIC family or Arduino families or any ARM families, you may notice all physical pins which are available across different pin numbers, so which is not fixed. So you may find different pin numbers related to these protocols. Now you're going to look this UART protocol, how this UART protocol works and what way which allows to send or receive data between microcontroller and external device. So the data frame is very simple, which allows one start bit. The logic is 0 and the data and stop bit logic is 1. So this data you can fix it as a programmer based on the different modes of serial communication. But mostly you are looking 8-bit characters. So any character having its own standard size, which is cap, 1 byte size. If you are looking to send character A, then you need to send the equivalent ASCII equivalent value is, which is 65. If you convert it to hexadecimal, which is 41H. And if you are writing in BCD format, 01000001. So this is your equivalent binary data whenever you are sending your characters from one device to another device. So this information which is passes bit by bit, because which allows serial communication. Serial communication basic thing is transmit or receive bit by bit. That is your basic approach. Now I am looking to initialize the serial communication. The serial communication is working on two standard SFR resistors you need to know, which are SCOM and SBUF. So these two resistors are very important to understand how serial communication can be initialized and what is the status of transmission, what is the status of receiving. All these things you can manage with the help of these two SFR resistors. The first register, which is SCON, this register itself, which is serial control resistor. And this register is an 8-bit register. This register helps to initialize the serial communication, and you can decide the mode. All these things you need to do with the help of SCON register bits. And this is a bit addressable register. Bit addressable meaning is you can access individual bits of SCON. So let's see what are the 8 bits of SCON resistor. And this is your LSB bit and MSB bit. And bits individual is SM0, SM1, and one unused bit, and REN, which is receive enable bit, and TB8, transmit bit 8, RB8, receive bit 8, TIRN. So these are 8 individual bits from SCON register. By default, all bits logics are zeros. So default hexadecimal value is 00H. But as a programmer, what happens whenever you are making logic ones? And what happens if you keep logic zeros with the bits? The first two bits, SM0, SM1. So these two bits are mode selection bits of serial communication. Means how you are expecting your serial communication with microcontroller and external device. So anyway, if you have two bits, you will get four possibilities as 00 combination, 01 combination, 10 combination, and 11 combination. Assigning 00 for these two bits, your serial communication selected in mode 0. So for mode 0, what happens, which your serial communication have to do in shift register concept. What is meant by shift register, and what about fixed baud rate? So shift register means whatever the data you are looking to transmit with this data frame, every time you need to keep your original bit at LSB position. So anyway, every protocol has its own rule. From your 8-bit data, whether your LSB is transmitted first or MSB is transmitted first. For few protocols, this is standard rule, but from other protocols, you can decide whether you are looking to send MSB first or LSB first. So from UART, which is always allows to send least significant bit first and later, you need to do shift operation on this original data. So by sending your 1, next you need to apply shift operation on this data to keep it your next bit in LSB position. So in the case of mode 0, you need to do shift operation on your original data every time. And fixed baud rate. So generally the serial communication or parallel communication, which is decided baud rate also. So baud rate is also one of the important parameter while doing communication. Baud rate means, what is the standard definition of baud rate? The number of bits transmitted or received per second. How many bits you are trying to transmit per second. So that is your baud rate of devices. In the case of mode 0, there is no chance to fix the baud rate. There is no chance to change the baud rate according to your requirements. If you keep these two mode selection bits as 00, the first thing you need to do shift operation on data, and which is allowing fixed baud rate with XML device. Suppose if you are making these two bits logics as 01 combination, then this is mode 1. In this case, you can just place 8-bit data, no need to do any shift operation on actual data, and allowing variable baud rate. So while running program, or when running application, you can change your baud rates according to your external devices. So the baud rate, you may get 9600, 4800, 7200, 14400. That depends on your external device baud rate. You can change your baud rates of microcontroller by choosing mode 1 from serial communication. And 1-0 combination is mode 2. So this mode 2 allows 9-bit data between start and stop bits. So as a programmer, you can decide data size also here. So whether you are looking to fix 8-bit data or 9-bit data by changing your mode. So you can place 9-bit data between start and stop by selecting mode 2 from SM0 and SM1. But this allows fixed baud rate. You can place 9-bit data between start and stop, but you cannot change the baud rate as 1-0 combination. And 1-1 combination is mode 3. This allows 9-bit data between start and stop with variable baud rate. So this is the importance of two mode selection bits from SCON resistor, SM0, SM1. So these two bits decide which mode you are expecting for serial communication. But most of the cases, you will proceed with mode 1, because here I am looking to send characters or numbers or special characters or anything here. All or most of the cases which are 8-bit size. So I will proceed most of the cases with mode 1 from SM0 and SM1 bits. And your next bit is unused, which is don't care. You can place it 1 or 0. There is nothing different for your serial communication. Then what about REN bit from SCON resistor? So REN full form is receive enable bit. And anything you are looking to receive data from external device to microcontroller, you need to enable this REN bit. The logic of REN. Logic 0, you don't want receive data from external device to microcontroller, which means you are trying to disable your receiving data. If you are making logic 1, which means you are giving 1 for this REN bit, the microcontroller accepts data from external device to microcontroller. You are looking to receive something from external device to microcontroller, which is receive enable. The REN bit logic decides whether you are looking to receive data or not. Then what about TB8, transmit bit 8. This is your stop bit error notification bit while doing transmission. If anything is wrong with this stop bit, because from your UART data frame, the last bit is stop bit. If anything is wrong with the stop bit logic while doing transmission, so this TB8 bit is automatically set to 1. If you are finding anything wrong with the stop bit logic in the case of transmission, your TB8 automatically becomes 1. Otherwise, it holds the default state logic 0. So this will become 1 if you are noticing that stop bit error while doing transmission. So this will work for only transmission. If you are finding any wrong thing with your stop bit logic, this bit automatically becomes 1. What about RP8? So this bit deals with receive process. This is receive bit 8. So this is 0 default. And whenever your stop bit error is, if you are finding any stop bit error while doing reception, if anything you are receiving from external device to microcontroller, if you are finding any wrong with your stop bit logic, this RB8 becomes 1. But this will work on only receiving. But this is how these two bit works. So TB8 deals with stop bit error while doing transmission, and RB8 deals with stop bit error while doing reception. Then what about TI and RI bits? TI full form is transmit interrupt. So this bit, which is default 0, and this bit becomes 1 whenever your 1 byte data is successfully transmitted from microcontroller to external device. So this indicates that successful transmission. Suppose if communication is still going on, the data which is still transmitting from microcontroller external device, this TA bit remains 0. So this is becoming 1 automatically whenever your data is successfully transmitted from microcontroller to external device. So this bit you are trying to use in program, because so this is one logic you need to use for successful transmission or transmission is going on. And the next bit is RI. This is your receive interrupt bit. So this bit remains 0 by default. If something you have received from external device to microcontroller, this RI automatically becomes 1. The RI logic is 1. Well, if data received from external device to microcontroller. This is the working of 8 individual bits from ISCON register. First 2 bits used for mode selection, or 00 mode 0, which is shift register with fixed baud rate, and 01 combination is mode 1, which is 8 bit data you can place between start and stop with variable baud rate, and 10 combination is mode 2, you can place 9 bit data between start and stop with fixed baud rate, and 11 combination is mode 3, you can place 9 bit data between start and stop with variable baud rate. And the next bit is REN. So this bit helps to receive enable. Anything you are looking to receive from external device to microcontroller, this should be 1. If you are keeping logic 0, your device doesn't accept anything from external device to controller. And TB8 and RB8 deals with stop bit error logic. If anything is wrong with your stop bit logic, these 2 bits are working on it. While doing transmission, if TB8 becomes 0 by default, it is becoming 1 if you are finding any stop bit error while doing transmission. And RB8 is 0 default, which is becoming 1 while doing reception if anything is wrong with the stop bit logic. And TI-RI bits are helping us to notice whether data is successfully transmitted or successfully received. If successfully transmitted, TA becomes 1, otherwise it is 0. And if data is received from external device microcontroller, RI is becoming 1. This is about your standard SFR registers. ISCON register bits, mostly will proceed with the logic 0, 1, and this is 0. If you are looking for receive operations, make it 1, or else make it 0. And TB8, RB8 remain 0, 0, and TA-RI by default, they are zeros. You need to test while doing transmission and receiving these bits logics. But most of the cases, what is your standard ISCON register hexadecimal value? You may find in programs, which is 0101 indicates that 5, and 40 says 5. So in embedded C programs, you may find ISCON value as 0x50, so that you just selected your serial communication with mode 1 and you just enabled your received REN bit. And these bits default zeros, they're changing according to the operation. Then what about the second register SBUF, which is data register, which is named as serial buffer register SBUF. SBUF is an 8 bit register. The capacity of your SBUF register is 1 byte size. So you can place any data into this SBUF. But it is not a bit addressable. You cannot access any single bit from ISCON register. So you need to access entire register to do your data operations. So for all serial communication operations, your SBUF is a data register. If you are looking to transmit anything, you need to place in SBUF to transmit. And you need to, if something is received from external device to microcontroller, the first data which is reached to SBUF. From SBUF 2, you can move it into any temporary variable from microcontrollers. So once you write one sample program, you can understand. So you need to follow the steps to establish serial communication with microcontroller with any external device. So you may deal with Bluetooth, you may deal with RFID readers, you may deal with GSM modules, GPS modules. So because there are many modules which are using nowadays for serial on-baseline serial communication programming. So serial communication is a very important feature towards applications. There are majority of the modules and sensors nowadays which are available on protocol basis. Maybe not only you are always, you may find I2C support sensors, I2C support modules like touch screen or MEMS sensors or RFID readers or accelerometers. There are many applications that depends on this protocol support. Okay, so that's why the serial communication feature is a very important to the microcontrollers. Not only 8051, every microcontroller supports this basic serial communication protocol, which is UART. So you need to understand the steps required for serial communication. So what are the steps required for serial communication? The first step is set SCON register value. So according to your mode selection and all, you need to decide your SCON register value. And the second step is select timer 1 in mode 2. So generally your timer selection purely decided by TMOD register. So you need to use TMOD register to choose your timer 1 in mode. And the third step is set the baud rate by using formula TH1 is equal to minus X. So this X is a programmable dividend. You need to discuss about this formula. So how to fix my X value? That is purely decided by crystal oscillator frequency. Let's see how to calculate this baud rate and all. But you need to remember these steps for serial communication. The first thing is you need to set SCON register value. Second step is select timer 1 in mode 2. And third step is the baud rate. You need to fix it by choosing X value, how much. And fourth step is start timer 1. So how to start timer 1? This is the bit from a TCON register, timer control register, which allows to TR1 bit, which provides TR1 bit from TCON register. So you need to make it logic 1 for that particular bit. And whatever the data you are looking to transmit, assign data to SBUF. So anything you are looking to transmit, keep your data with SBUF register. But your SBUF register doesn't hold strings or more characters. The capacity of SBUF is very clear, which allows only one byte, which means one character at a time. If you have multiple characters, you need to keep it this process in loop action. Okay, and the next step is wait until transmit interrupt becomes 1, which is until TI logic set to 1. So this is a step you need to follow, because the TI bit, which is becoming 1 whenever your data successfully transmitted. And next, clear TI and repeat the process if you have more data. If you have only single character, you can stop your timer. So these are the serial communication steps you need to follow to implement your data transmission with microcontroller and external device. So I think you can understand all these steps: SCON register value and timer 1 in mode 2 by using TMOD. But the thing is, how to set my baud rate by fixing my X value. So to calculate this baud rate, you need to know about these steps. So according to your microcontroller reset circuit, what is the crystal oscillator frequency you are taking here, which is 11.0592 MHz. So this frequency, so generally frequency definition is number of clock cycles generated per second. And what is the baud rate definition? Number of bits transmitted or received per second. So which means what the closest relation with frequency and baud rate? How many bits you are transmitting or receiving per second? how many clock cycles you are run generating per second. That will be decided by frequency. So which means internally every bit is associated with one clock cycle, because you have to keep this communication in synchronization with the clock. Even though it is an asynchronous communication, but every bit which uses one clock cycle per transmission or receive. So this frequency, which is divided with a standard or fixed divider 12. So this fixed divider, after this, whatever the frequency you are getting out of this block, which is given to on-chip UART block, and this on-chip UART block having a fixed divider 32. And this frequency again forwarded to a programmable dividend X, which means out of all this, whatever the frequency you are getting out of this block, that is the actual frequency or actual baud rate of microcontroller. So once you are dividing your 11.05 into megahertz with the 12, so you will get 11.0592 divided with 12 will get 0.921. This is in megahertz, and this frequency is divided with 32 divided, which is 0.0288 megahertz. So if you are converting this thing into hertz, 28,800 hertz, because it is in mega, you will get 10 power 6. So this frequency is 28,800 hertz. So this is the maximum baud rate of your 8051 microcontroller. And depends on your X. Suppose if I am placing X value is 1, then what is the output frequency of this block? 28,800. If I am keeping my X value as 2, this is X is equal to 1, and if you are keeping X value 2, so you are getting how much frequency out? 14,400. And X value is 3, you are getting 9,600. X value 4, 7,200, like this. See, mostly whatever the frequency I got here, 28,800, this is divisible with any integer number from 1 to 9. This is the only reason they are taking this 11.05 into frequency. Otherwise, they will go with the standard or regular integer level frequencies like 12, 24, or 10, 4. So this is all. The actual range of 8051 families is 4 MHz to 40 MHz. But they are working with this typical frequency, which is 11.05 into here, because of to support serial communication without getting this frequency in any points. But this basic controller, which is having all our dividers, but once you move to next level families, you may get multipliers, which means your frequency is doubled internally. So, but your 8051, which is supporting very low frequency, which means you are working with very low baud rates. Depends on external device, you can fix how much baud rate you are looking as per your dividend. But most of the cases, you will go with the standard baud rate for all devices, mostly like GSM module or GPS or RFID readers. They will work with the standard baud rate 9600. So mostly your X value you may find 3. This is the thing you need to understand to fix the baud rate of microcontroller by choosing X value. But what about this minus? So generally, how it takes negative numbers into the microcontrollers? So you cannot proceed or you cannot assign any negative numbers to the registers. But if you are giving still minus 3 across TH1 register, it will take its equivalent 2's complement. The 2's complement means you will get some 0xFD for your minus 3. The 2's complement means one's complement plus one. So these are the steps, and calculating baud rate is very clear. Now I'll write one sample program to transmit a first letter of name. So I'm just following the same steps here. I'll write one basic embedded C program, so which is reg51.h, hash include reg51.h, so that it allows to use all SFRs without any declaration. And then I'll directly write in main. So what is the first step according to serial communication? Set the SCON register value. So what is the SCON register value? You need to fix it. If you are expecting both transmission and receiving, you can fix REN bit 1. If you are looking only transmission, you can make it 0. So if you are making this bit 0, you will get 40. Or if you are expecting both, you will get 40. So I am directly assigning SCON register value as 0x50 as per my first step. And second step is select timer 1 in mode 2. So for that, TMOD value is 0x20. So this is we discussed in the previous session, which is TMOD registers and their hexadecimal values. And the third step is set the baud rate. So how I am fixing my TH1 value, which is minus x, but now looking for 9600 baud rate, so I am assigning 3 for TH1 register. Baud rate is 9600, because you have to keep your microcontroller baud rate as per external device baud rate. If you are having different baud rates for external device and microcontroller, you are losing your data between devices. And fourth step is start timer 1. So how to start? It is a simple. You need to assign logic 1 for TR1 bit, and then assign your data to SBUF. So whatever the character you are looking to transmit, assign with SBUF. So I'm just placing my character in single quotes to make character constant. So SBUF is filled with one single character. Don't assign any string or multiple characters with SBUF, because SBUF capacity is 1 byte. And I'm still waiting for TI logic until sets to 1. So I'm using while keyword with a semicolon. While TI equals to 0 and terminated with semicolon, so that it will wait for transmission successful. And TI 0 and stop timer 1. This is for one single character transmission between microcontroller and external device. Any external device you are connecting across RXD and TXD pins of microcontroller. Maybe what is your physical diagram? So I am just doing microcontroller, and across P3.0, which is pin number 10 and 11, you may find RXD and TXD pins. So once you are activating your serial communication with SCON register, the pins 10 and 11 used as serial communication lines, not IO lines. So you need to do cross connection with the external device always. So whatever the external device you are taking here, so anyway, the external device also have the same physical lines RXD and TXD. You need to do cross connection with external device. Like external device RXD should be connected with TXD of microcontroller, and TXD of external device has to connect with RXD pin of microcontroller. This is your physical connection need to do with two devices, between microcontroller and external device. So this is one sample program, but according to your external devices like RFID, if you are supposed working with RFID reader, so you have only receiving part in that case. So you need to connect the transmission line of RFID, you have to connect with the receiving line of microcontroller. Suppose if you are dealing with some GSM module, which is global mobile communication system, which is for to do calls or SMS operations with any application basis, or else you are trying to communicate with personal computer, even personal computer also supports microcontroller board communication, but you need to search for RXD and TXD lines from the personal computer, which are available at DB9 connector. from PC. So that depends on what kind of application you are approaching. Whether you are trying to communicate your microcontroller with personal computer or RFID readers or GSM or Bluetooth or fingerprint or Wi-Fi modules. There are many applications are available with a serial communication feature with microcontrollers. Please subscribe our channel Aerotech Solutions from YouTube, and if you have any inquiries on this topic, please comment, or you can write any query with the email aerotechsolve@gmail.com. I'll provide all the details in the description. Thanks for watching.